Quelle horreur, I'm not even dressed. But come in, quick, close the door. Those ladies across the hall, they must not see me speak to an Englishman in my negligee. American school teachers, they think the worst of every French woman. And you too will think the worst of me. I truly never believe you will come, otherwise I will be dressed. Oh, quelle disgrâce, it's only yesterday you meet me, you do not even meet me. Oh, what sort of a meeting is that? You are walking in the bois. I go past you in my carriage, and you look at me. I did not look at you. I look at you looking at me. I did not smile. Well, not to you. At you, peut-être, as one may smile at, oh, je ne sais pas, an amusing object. You are a British object, it's always amusing. But if I have known that 5 minutes later my carriage break down, I will not even have smiled at you. Oh, such a stupid accident. All the fault of that ridiculous Herbert, my coachman. He should have made examen of the wheel. He should have known it would come loose. When my husband returns from Lyon, I shall tell him he will give Herbert his congé. Oh, no. Oh, I should not tell him that. Ooh. If ever my husband find out I allow a man to speak to me, even an Englishman, ooh la la, no. I shall tell him the carriage break down, that while Herbert fix it, I am obliged to sit on a bench for 1 hour. I do think it was an enchanting hour. It enchanted me into doing something I never believe I will do, to give to a stranger my name and address. Ah, but you are a stranger, and please now, you will leave. Oh, pardon, monsieur, is no rendezvous. I merely tell you I am home every afternoon between 4 and 5, and that my husband has gone on a business trip to Lyon. And you arrive so early. Well, I am still in my negligee. Oh, I feel like a cocotte. Oh, but to every Englishman, every Parisian is a cocotte. How can I believe you? Oh, there is nothing you could give me. Your ring? Oh, jamais de la vie, is a diamond ring. And such a big, big diamond. If ever my husband see it, what will he do? It's very simple. He will strangle me. Oh, no, monsieur. Never could I accept such a thing. Well, just to amuse, I can put it on for only the time that you are here, because you may remain for only a few minutes, and I must go get into my dress. Oh, quelle impudence! Of course you may not watch me. There, you see, you do think I am a bad woman. Otherwise, you will never suggest anything so wicked until you know me better. Oh, at least 2 weeks. Tomorrow. Mais pourquoi? Why should anybody go to England ever? Ah, non, monsieur. Non, 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 non. Non, 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 non. Oh, non, 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 non. Oh. Écoutez, monsieur, écoutez. I am a good woman. Always I have been faithful to my husband. How can I believe you are sincere? You know I cannot keep on your ring. Your stick pin. But that too is diamonds. How am I to explain to my husband a diamond stick pin? Unless I put it in the little écrin where I keep the miniature of my mama. diamonds, how brightly they shine.
Monsieur, just because you remove your stick pin is no reason you should also remove your necktie and collar. Shh! Somebody's coming up the stairs. He's perhaps the man to fix the gas. I will bolt the door. He will think nobody is here and go away. Oh! A key in the lock. He's my husband. He will kill you. He will kill me too. Killa! Those back stairs. Hurry.
C'est toi?
Hurry, down those stairs.
Quelle surprise!
Dépêchez-vous, voyons. Non, 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 non. Adieu, adieu. You cannot see me tomorrow. Goodbye, goodbye. Adieu, adieu.
Mais je ne t'attendais pas, voyons.
Mais oui, je viens tout de suite. Entrez donc, mon ami. Come on in, Herbert. Cripe short of seeing him run. He'll be off way down the blooming road to Calais in no time. And with his tie and collar off, he was an easy one. Not bad. A ring and a diamond stick pin. Not a chance of it. He's off to dear old London tomorrow. A few more hours like this, we'd be getting back there ourselves, I hear, but no business for us goes better here in Paris. Ah, of course this is a good day. Some 1,300 francs worth of diamonds, and me virtue intact. Oh, look, the bloke left his top hat and his cane and his gloves behind. I'll put them on. I say, Herbert, how's this for a sissy loftus?